known that come to know that the bubbles are these are the two bubbles, array of j and array of j plus 1. If it is not in order, okay, then we will perform the swapping operation, right? Am I clear?
Yes sir.
Okay, now what is the advantage of a bubble sort? Bubble sort perform that big of n square time complexity, right? We have analyzed in the earlier case big of n square time complexity. It requires big of n square time complexity because to sort one element it takes big of n minus 1, to sort another element it takes big of n minus 2, to sort another element it takes big of n plus n minus 3, and so on. If you add it up, it will become n into n minus 1 divided by 2, that becomes big of n square. Okay, so big of n square time complexity is too high for bubble sort, any sorting method. So where is the use of bubble sort, or why should we study the bubble sort? It has an advantage, another advantage. Let me explain what is the advantage of bubble sort. Okay, this advantage is that big of n square, it is worst time, well, it is bad, very bad time complexity, because big of n square is that it takes huge time. Okay, so let me take an example that is nearly sorted array. Okay, this is I have termed it as a nearly sorted array. So this is nearly sorted array, then few flips of that bubbles can sort entirely. So let me go to the animation. Okay, this animation compares 1 and 2. Okay, 1 and 2. So one is this is not in order, that's why we need to exchange 1 and 2. So next, so this is 1 and 2, so it should be exchanged, and this is we have exchanged here, we have exchanged 1 and 2. So this 1 and 2 has been exchanged and it is now sorted. Now check with 2 and 4. It is already sorted or already in order, we need not to exchange. And check 4 and 3, it is not in order. So 4 and 3, so we need to exchange it. So we need to exchange, we have exchanged. So next, check 4 and 6. Next, we need to check whether this 4 and 6 is already in order. It is already in order, now we need to exchange. And 6 and 5, is it already in order? No, it is not already in order, or that's why 6 is greater than 5, that's why we need to swap. We need to exchange. So we have exchanged, then it is in order right now. So compare 6 and 8. Is it in order? 6 and 8. Is it in order? Yes, it is in order. No need to exchange. So compare 8 and 7. Compare 8 and 7. Is it in order? No. So it is not in order. That's why we need to exchange. 7 and 8 has been exchanged. Now 8 and 10. Is it in order? 8 and 10. Yes, it is in order. So 10 and 9, is it in order? So it is not in order, that's why we need to exchange it. 9 and 10 should be exchanged. So 9 and 10. Now 10 and 11. Next, 10 and 11. So we need to compare 10 and 11. Is it in order? Yes, it is in order. That's why we need not to do anything. So we need to compare 12 and 11. So 12 and 11, is it in order? No, it is not in order. That's why we need to exchange. So if you continue like this, for 12 and 14 is already in order. 14 and 13 is already in order, not already in order. So we should exchange 14 and 13. So we have already exchanged here 13 and 14. So 14 and 16, compare it. Is it in order? So it is in order. So it should not be exchanged. Now 16 and 15. So 15 it is not in order. We need to exchange. We have exchanged. Now can you check it out? That is it in already? It is sorted. The array is sorted. It is sorted, right? So what is the comparison time complexity? We have compared 1 with 2, 2 with 3, 3 with 4, 4 with 5, 5 with 6, 6 with 7, 7 with 8, and so on. And we have completed the, we have completed the sorting phase. So what is the time complexity? Can you say what is the time complexity? Can someone say what is the time complexity?
I guess O of N.
O of N. Because it takes N minus 1 comparison. After N minus 1, it has already been sorted. Okay. So the time complexity is big O of N. Here I have put mistakenly big O of 1. Okay, it is not big O of 1. It should be big O of N, right? So this advantage, this is the advantage of bubble sort. If it is nearly sorted, then you should not run up to big O of N square time. It can be completed within the few iteration or few pass. In a single phase, you can solve the problem. So how will you write the code? Earlier code was there. So void bubble sort int array A, int N. So this were that. I have introduced flag. Here I have introduced the flag. Okay, this is a flag. So if flag is equal to 0, then I'll compare all bubbles, near bubbles. I'll compare all bubbles. Okay, if flag is swap, exchange, okay, sorry, if there is an, two bubbles are not in order, then flag equal to 1. If two bubbles are not in order, then flag equal to 1. Then continue. So it will repeat until the one element is not sorted. Then if it is not in order, then flag equal to 1. So flag equal to 1, is it 1? No. So it won't break. Then I equal to increase. I will increase. I become 1. So j equal to 0, j less than n minus 1 minus 1. That means 1 total item, 1 has been decreased. So after this, here we will check two bubbles. Two bubbles. This is one bubble. This is another bubble. So these two bubbles, we will check these two bubbles. Okay, these two bubbles, one and two bubbles. Then these bubbles are, is it in order? Yes, it is already in order. That's why we need not to go inside. Then compare 2 and 3. Is it in already order? Yes, it is already in order. We need not to go inside because flag is here 0. Okay, next 3 and 4. Here 3 and 4. Can you see my marker? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Three and four. Now 3 and 4. This 3 and 4, is it in order? Yes. So it won't go inside. So 4 and 5, 5 and 6, up to 15. Okay. Up to 15, it will not go inside. So what remains is that flag equal to 0 still remain after completion of this. J equal to 0, to J is less than n minus I minus 1. Then it become, if flag equal to 0, 0 is equal to 0, reach through, then break. Break means which loop it will break? This loop. This for loop will break. That means no need to sort. So what will be the time complexity? Only this much of the time complexity. So how many comparison we have done using this loop? Can someone say?
2n.
2n. Exactly. 2n. N minus 1 plus n minus 2. Exact operation is that first we have to compare up to this. That means it will take n minus 1. Is it? Then plus. Next, it will decrement, right? Here, I will increment. So, n minus I become 1. Here, earlier it was 0. Now, n minus 1. It will decrement. Total number of item will be decrement from 15 to 14. So, it will compare. Next phase, it will compare up to 1 to 15. So, it become n minus 2. So it become twice n. So twice n minus 3. So it is constant, we don't write. So n is 2 is also constant, we don't write in big O notation, right? So time complexity is big O of n. So the time complexity is big O of n, right? So here, this is the modified bubble sort. Am I clear? Yes, do you have any question regarding bubble sort?
Sir, the flag is there just to prevent it from going again if everything, there was no swap, right?
Yeah. If flag means, so what? If it is already sorted,
then don't okay,
no need to go more. No need to run it again and again, right? It yes, will break. Okay. To prevent the loop, this loop to continue, this loop to continue. Okay, otherwise it n into n square time complexity, so it will be taking huge time even if it is already sorted items, right? Am I clear?
Yes sir.
So when okay. Do we use it?
Yes sir.
Where do we use? A bubble sort doesn't have any useful uses. Okay, so this is the very good question. Where do we use it? Bubble sort doesn't have any uses because it has a worst time case. Time complexity is the worst case. Time complexity is big of n square, and best case time complexity is big of n square. Best case time complexity, big of n. Then average case time complexity is big of n square. However, if we go into that insertion sort, it perform better than bubble sort. Insertion sort perform better than bubble sort. Okay, less comparison, less movements are there. So bubble sort doesn't have any useful area. So we don't use. We just study to learn. Maybe in future someone can develop this, modify this algorithm to improve the sorting technique. Okay. So that we have insertion sort. Okay. So we have insertion sort. Now, insertion sort, a loop invariant. We have loop invariant. So can I complete it? So for today, okay, I'll complete it. I'll keep it for today. Time is almost completed. So any question from bubble sort or selection sort, you can ask. Do you have any kind of questions?
No, sir.
No question. In the next lab, I'll put question from insertion sort, selection sort, and bubble sort. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir. Am I clear? Touchstone short, bubble short.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And?
Yes, sir.
And the test cases is that your array size, array allocation should be random number. Okay, array allocation should be random number, and it may be very large. Okay, it may be very small, but the array allocation should be dynamic. Dynamic allocation. You cannot allocate this array size in static. So random number, I have given the code how to generate the random numbers, right?
Yes, yes. Sir, okay. By dynamic allocation, do we mean by using random function or malloc function?
Malloc.
Okay, sir.
To allocate, you need malloc function. To generate random number, you need stdlib.h. Then you have to write
SRAND
instead of random, or you need not to write, or just rand bracket, and then within the range, given range. Maybe you can generate the given range, or you may not, if you are not interested in given range, then you may not be interested. So that the range, within the range, or may not be range, but total number of items can be input by user. Okay, can be input by user. So this n should be input by user, and random will be, this total items will be assigned by the random function. Array is assigned by random function. So random integer, obviously we'll use random integer. So we'll assign random integer, and we'll check the performance, which performance is better, bubble sort, selection sort, or insertion sort. We'll compare, and we have to draw, okay, we have to draw curve like this. This is one curve, and say for example, for the best case scenario, selection sort is taking this much of time, and this is best case. And selection sort and insertion sort is taking this much of time. Say for example, desired output, and then average case. Say for example, selection sort is taking this time, and this time, and this time. Say for example, and worst case. Maybe this is average case, this is worst case, this is best case. So this is the time t. So you need to generate, this is the desired output. Okay, this is the desired output, and you need to compare. So how will you going to write the code is clock time dot h. In the time dot h, you write clock is underscore t, then time start, say for example start or end. So I'll give the code for that, how to measure one particular this time from here to here, what is the running time. I'll give the code. Okay, so tomorrow we'll discuss about insertion sort. Okay, for today. So I have to close today. I have to complete the class today. Okay, I'm ending the class. Okay, if you have question, you can ask the question tomorrow. Okay,
sir.
Yes, yes.
Sir, the students who have recently transferred. Sir, the students who have recently changed the branch, when should they submit the lab assignments?
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
For them, what will I do? We'll exempt the class assignment. Okay.
So we don't have to do any previous assignments.
Previous assignment.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you all. Okay.
Thank you.